It's time to dish with Dee. That's me. This is a video long in the promising. Ellen, this is for you. Eggplants. Yes, I have two different types of eggplants. I have the Japanese eggplant that I think a lot of you might know. And I also have one you might not know. This is something that's, I don't know if it's local to where I live, but I've never seen it until I moved to New Jersey. It is a Sicilian eggplant. It is a little lighter in color and it's round. These and this, they both have less seeds. Why I kind of love these are only out during the summer over here, so I didn't see many of them this year. I'm a little bit sad. I don't know if it had to do with COVID or whatever. I don't know. I haven't seen much of it. So we're gonna make some eggplant, breaded eggplant in the air fryer and eggplant what I call fries. Now, I am not using my air fryer because not everybody has an air fryer. But if you do have an air fryer, you definitely can put them in your air fryer and air fry them up. I believe the temperature would be like 375. Not sure of the time because I haven't, I usually just do it in my oven. I'm an oven girl and my oven's cranking up to 450. And you'll see that with a plain conventional oven, you can get crunchy eggplant too without frying it. I've always made it here, so I figured why, if it isn't broke, don't fix it. I make it this way all the time. So why change just because I happen to have an air fryer? Again, I'm a creature of habit. You'll find that here with the old deer. Yeah, I'm very conventional. So what we're gonna do, now you could leave the peel on. That's a personal preference. I take it off. But again, it's totally edible. You can leave it on. I like to take it off. So I'm gonna, I'll show you real quick how I peel them. But I think, you know, but I figured just for, as we say, shits and giggles, I'm gonna peel it for you. So let's get started, shall we? Alrighty. I always like to peel this little thingy. It's like the, you know, like the stem part. Peel that up. And then get that. And I always like to cut the bottom off. And then, like I said, with a, you have to get yourself a good sharp peeler and just peel it like that. We're gonna peel that all the way around. Same thing with the Japanese. Just get a little end off. Same thing with this one. I like to peel these off first. I don't know why. It's just the way I've always done it. And then cut the top off. Then we will peel this all the way down. So I'm gonna do this and we're gonna come back. I'm gonna cut them and we're gonna show you how we're going to bread them. Again, breading is funny because I'm using a cup of breadcrumb, which is 9 points. Am I gonna eat that whole cup of breadcrumb? Absolutely not. But we will discuss how I point them out. And then again, you can choose to do however you choose to do it. But let me peel these and we're gonna get back and get to it. Okay, we have our eggplant all peeled. Now we can decide how we wanna do these. Now I'm gonna leave these since they're round. We'll do the, we'll see. I never know what I'm gonna do before I decide to film. So I'm just gonna cut these in nice even rounds. You can see that the seeds in these are very small compared to the big purple ones. And as thick as you make them, you know, they might cook a little bit longer. You could do it thinner, but I find they tend to burn that way. So I like to do an even maybe, it's maybe a little more than a quarter inch. It's too funky, so we'll leave that one here. And these, I'm just going to little discs. Trying to be even, the same, you want the same thickness in all your eggplant as best as you can. Nobody's perfect. And like we said, we're not on the Food Network here. We're home cooks just having a good time getting together. Nobody's here is on television. Please, no right or wrong. Okay, so we have all our eggplant cut. So I'm gonna use the one that was a little bit wonky, which was this one. So I'm gonna cut it into planks. These are gonna be our eggplant fries. Do them all planks, you don't have to make fries. I just kind of like little matchsticks of eggplant. There was another wonky piece too. This one was wonky. This one was the one I was thinking of. So instead of a traditional french fry, you're going to have an eggplant french fry. I know, sounds amazing, doesn't it? And they're just gonna be little discs. Now again, they're just adorable, aren't they? You can see there's hardly any seeds in these. So Japanese happen to be my personal favorite. So now we have our breading station. Right here, I have my egg wash. It's just egg with a little bit of 1% milk, not even enough to worry about. I like to season it. Emerald Gossi always seasoned his, so I season mine. Salt, pepper, I have some Flavor God in there. And I have here, I believe it's seasoned breadcrumbs. A cup. A cup is 9 points. Now, am I going to eat this whole cup of breadcrumbs? No. So you decide a portion that you feel. Definitely give it points. Like, you might want, it depends on how much you have. I mean, you're not going to give it all 9 because you're not going to eat this whole, though you could eat this whole entire plate. And we're done. We're going to see how much breadcrumb we have left over. And I will measure that and we could take that off of our total as well. But I always err on the side of a little bit of extra. And I definitely like the seasoned. You could use panko. It would probably be lower in points, but I love the seasoned. I think it adds a little something. It just does. You know, but you know what? You do what you need to do, and that's how we roll here at the Dish with D headquarters. All right, I need a plate. Did I bring another plate? It's almost right here. Duh. Eggplant's on. I need to grab another plate. I want to have a plate for our breaded product. So let's move this out of the way. It's right over here. Okay. I always say wet hand, dry hand. It never works out that way, but I tried. You could try, use tongs. Yeah, never works out that way. Let's start with the big pieces, shall we? Beautiful piece of eggplant. We dunk it. Some people dunk it in flour, then the breadcrumb, but I don't think it really needs it. You get it nice and moist. And then we just, again, see, wet hand, dry hand. This is our dry hand. And you just coat it. And then I like to do the sides because, you know, press. You can see it's a very thin coating of breadcrumb. Not a lot. And we'll do another big one. Like that. What I love about doing it in the oven is there really is no chance for this to come off because you're not really messing with it too much. I find when I used to put in the oil and it just would always kind of separate. So now let's do some of these fries. So dunk a few of them in there. And again, like I said, this is not necessary, but I love, there's a restaurant that's not too far from where I live and they make the best eggplant. They call them eggplant fritas, which is, I guess, french fries. And we just love them. We're eggplant people here. You wouldn't know it that I have not an eggplant recipe on this channel. See, it's not a lot. Just a little coating, just to give it a little something something. You could dip these in ketchup, marinara, whatever you like to dip your french fries in, or nothing at all. They're really good on their own. Now, I like to make eggplant parm with this, since I'm on WW. I like to, and I live in New Jersey, I love to put a big, big piece of Jersey tomato on top, fresh, not cooked, and then some grated Parmesan cheese, and that's how I like it. Even if you take this out to your grill and just brush it with a little olive oil and grill it, and then do the same thing with the tomato and the Parmesan cheese. Not only have you saved a few points with not having the breading, but it's different. And I think, you know, sometimes in our journey, we need a little to jazz things up because we get a little complacent and we get a little bit bored, a little bit bored with our food. So I'm always trying to, you know, change things up and especially you can remember, this is a lifestyle, not a diet. You know, you want to eat the foods you grew up with, at least I do. And foods that you really enjoy. Like, you don't want to be eating just grilled chicken, you know. You want to have some eggplant parm. It ends on plan. You just have to prepare it and plan for it. And you too can have a delicious low point meal. I'm going to finish breading these and then we'll come back and I will show you right before they go into the oven. All right, we have all of our eggplant breaded. I did have some breadcrumbs left over, probably almost a quarter a cup. So then we just say we use 3/4 of a cup. So I have my foil lined baking tray. I'm going to place my eggplant on these little ones down here, our little discs. We've got a variety of eggplant. We're gonna place some of our little strippy ones, our little, what I call eggplant french fries, just all around. They all may bake at different times, so when you check on it, you just remove the ones that are done and put the other ones back in. I'm gonna grab another tray, I think, for the rest. I'm gonna put these in the oven. They're going to bake probably, I'm gonna keep checking on them because I'm really, you know, you're never quite sure. Sometimes it's always different. Just you never know how hot your oven is that day. So I'm gonna put these in. I'm gonna leave them in for probably 20 minutes. Check it, and if they need to be flipped, I will flip them. And if I want to, maybe I'll bring you guys back to show you what they look before I flip them. How's that? All right, put these down. Before we put them in, I almost forgot. I'm going to spray them with a little bit of Pam spray to help the crunching process. Little whiz. Put these in. We're gonna leave them in for 20 minutes. We're gonna come back and check them. Pulled it out of the oven. It was baking for 20 minutes. Look how beautiful and brown they're already getting. It's not gonna need much more. I'm gonna put them back in for another probably 10 minutes just to make sure the other side is cooked through, but I'm sorry. These are just as good, if not better, than a traditional fried eggplant. Alrighty. Some of it's out of the oven and I just wanted to show you how beautiful, like I said, just an oven, not an air fryer. Look at the crisp on this. It's amazing. Now, how I like to serve it, again, you could serve it with your typical marinara and mozzarella, but I like to, since I'm paying for this, now, how much would I charge you for breadcrumbs? We used probably 7 points worth, 8 maybe to stretch. If I had 2 pieces, I might charge myself a point. Just to cover my butt. But really, if you're not only gonna have a few, I wouldn't really worry about it, but you have to do what you feel comfortable with. So I like to just throw some beautiful Jersey tomato on top like that. We always salt and pepper our tomatoes here in New Jersey. And a little bit of, this happens to be Pecorino Romano's, but I happen to have one hand. So there you have it. I am not paying for that little bit of cheese. There you have your eggplant parm, WW-fied by D. Now let's taste these french fries, shall we? All right, let's check. Let's taste. Oh, I've had a bad afternoon. Our french fries. You can dip them in, I'm dipping them in ketchup, but you could absolutely dip them in marinara, whatever you feel like it. Listen. Crunchy, tender, and delicious. No oil required. So there you have D's eggplant. It's how I do it, it's how I've always done it the last few years, and no reason to change now. If you enjoyed this video, this is for you, Ellen. Give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't already subscribed, please consider subscribing, hit the notification bell. You hit all and it tells you when I upload, when I go live, and who doesn't want to know when I go live to see something as fantastic as eggplant parm, WW-fied. No, again, like I said, you absolutely could put sauce and cheese, but I just like it with the fresh Jersey tomato. That's because I'm a Jersey girl. Don't tell my Philly peeps. Have a great day. We will dish another day. Thanks, guys.